Today is the day. The meat birds are going out of the brooder on the pasture. So I gotta put the bell waters together and get the 5 gallon buckets, get those set up, put the feeders together, and then we can put the birds out on pasture. So get started on that now. Okay, so these things are pretty easy to set up. This is called a bell water. It comes with this tub, the bell, a cover, and a bag. And really the only thing you need if you're hooking it up to a 5 gallon bucket is a drill with a drill bit, and you're gonna need a bucket of water. So taking everything out of the packaging, there's some stuff that you don't need, for some stuff I don't need for this setup. So I need a string. This is for the hose. You need this ring and a spring. The rest of this stuff can go back in the bag because I don't need it for my setup. So first things first, take the hopper and this tube. I want to put that through and then fill up this with water. This is the weight that activates the bell. So you could use sand, dirt, gravel. I'm just gonna use water because it's easy. Put the lid on. And take the red washer or nut. Screw that on. So it's tight. Put the bell over the top. Oh. Put the spring on first, then put the bell over the top. And then the top piece of the bell can go on. You don't want it super tight on there, so. Want to leave a little gap. I don't know if you can see on camera, but there's a little gap between this white top and the bell, and that's what you want, because then with the spring inside, when this fills up with water, the weight pushes it away. So that'll make more sense in a second once I get it fully assembled. So then the plunger goes on. Okay, now you can hook up the tube. So what happens is, from your 5 gallon bucket, once this is hooked up, the water comes in, and then with no water in the bell, there's no weight on the bell. So once the water goes in, the weight of the water pushes down, and then this little black piece inside this plunger no longer hits the bell, so then that'll stop water once it fills up all the way. So that's how you assemble the bell. As for the water bucket, I don't have any fittings for this hose, so I already did one and I tried it. So I'm just gonna drill a 1/4 inch hole in this bucket towards the bottom. Then what I'll do is heat up the hose a little bit. And then stick that inside the hole in the bucket. And then, as you can see in there, it's just pressure fitting and it won't leak out. And being that it's in the bottom of the bucket, it'll still fill up with water. So now we can bring these over to the chicken tractors and get them installed. I'm gonna assemble the other one real quick and then we'll bring them over. We'll install them and we'll fill up the buckets with water and I'll show you how that works. Okay, so just thread the string through the top and I'm just gonna tie a knot. They send a little hook, but I'm not a huge fan of it, so I just tie the string to the water and then we'll tie it here to cross support. And I just wrap it around a couple times. Get the height that I like. They're pretty easy to move, so if I need to move it due to the size of the birds, I can do that in the future. So now we got the bucket. Just gonna put it where I want it. I'm gonna leave a little extra hose, but I don't want a ton of extra hose. They send, I think it's 10 feet of hose, so you have plenty of hose. This is actually a scrap from one of the other ones that I did. So easiest way I found, just heat up the end. See if I can do it with the wind. Just heat up the end a little bit and then it slides right on. And then this piece can reattach. And now we're good to go. Okay, we got these 4-foot plastic trough feeders. They go together super easy. Just have to screw in the handle. The key to these is screwing them in tight enough, but then also loose enough where it'll spin. So that way if the chicken tries to jump up on top of it, they can't use it for a roost. They'll kind of spin right off. If they use it for a roost, they will end up pooping in the feed and just making a big mess. So if you leave these a little bit loose, they cannot do that. So we got one of these for each tractor. One of them's already put together. We've been using that in the brooder because they were going crazy with the little feeders and eating them up. So we ended up having to use one of these inside of the brooder. So we already got one together. So good. All right, we got feed, gotta fill up the waters, then we'll be ready for chicken. Okay, so now when I fill these up, you can see the bell water will start filling up. So that will just go now until the bell water fills up all the way due to enough weight, and then it'll stop. So there it is, it's topped off and it stopped. So you can adjust this piece on the top. You can adjust this so that it doesn't fill up as much, or so that it fills up more. That right there for me is about perfect. So now we can go get the chicken. Okay, so we're using these crates. Hopefully they won't jump out. But if they do, they're slow and we should be able to catch them. So we're gonna get them loaded up and then move them to the chicken tractor. Size difference is pretty wild. These are not even the biggest and the smallest. There's definitely one bigger than this that we put in the first, and then there's definitely one that's way smaller than this. So 2-3 weeks in one day, and the size difference is pretty crazy. The feet on them are massive already though, so pretty cool to see.
It's harder to bend over. Can you get it?
So close.
So close.
It's like that TV commercial with a guy with a dollar on the fishing pole. He almost got it. Just stay close. Mm-hmm. Crazy, these birds, as soon as they get out on grass, they go right to scratching and pecking and eating grass and looking for bugs. It's pretty wild. All right, so we got all the birds out of the brooder and onto the pasture. We got 97?
Yep, 97.
97 birds. I think we ordered 105, 106. And then they sent, I don't know, maybe a couple extras. So we did have a little bit of loss. A lot of that was in the beginning.
Yes.
We did lose one yesterday, day before.
Yes.
Which is kind of a bummer because we fed it for 3 weeks. It looks like it had something wrong on the back side of it, the back end of it. Some sort of health issue, I think. So, but that's pretty good. So it's pretty satisfying to see them out here. We ordered these birds in, what, 7 months ago?
Yeah.
Seven months ago we ordered these birds in preparation for this. So it's pretty satisfying to see them out here now. It's been a long time coming. So another 5 weeks, we can get them processed. We're planning a process on Halloween, I think. That'll be 8 weeks to the day. So we'll do it right around Halloween, give or take. But so far, pretty happy with them. Should be cool to see what they can do to the grass. It's kind of patchy in areas, and the property's just been neglected. So it's been used for hay for the last 40 years at least. So just nothing going back into it. So it should be pretty cool to see what the chickens can do. So looking forward to it. All right, we got the brooder cleaned up and set for the hens. So I think the hens are happy. It's like when their older brother moves out to college or goes off into the world and they have the house to themselves. So they got feed, they got water. They should keep this thing a little bit cleaner. And they'll be in here for probably another week. Maybe a week and a half, 2 weeks, just depends. I want them to get a little bit bigger before they go out into the electric net, so we'll see how long they're in here for. All right, so we're out here this morning. I'm gonna move the chicken tractors. All the chickens made it through the night. So I don't know how well they're gonna do with the move. They've never done it before, so to do it for a couple days, I'm sure they'll be able to figure it out and move with the chicken tractor, but we'll try the first one and see how it goes. All right, well, they figure it out pretty quick to start moving forward. The first chicken tractor, not so much, but this one only had one bird get a foot stuck under, but that's why I was going slow. You can hear them. They start crying out, basically, and then just push it back a little bit, gets unstuck, and then these ones, they were probably 6 inches in front of the edge, 6 inches to a foot in front of the back side. So they're kind of figuring it out. So we got one more to go, and then typically with these, if you look up Joel Salatin and the way he does it, they have a dolly on the backside which raises up that back panel so that when you're pulling it, if one gets trapped back there, it just goes underneath the tractor and then you can pick it up and put it back in. It doesn't get hurt. So I'll probably end up building something like that for this.
just to keep any injuries on the lower side. There's also a company called Chick Lift that has a wheel system that's kind of cool. We'll get the last one moved and then show you what they did yesterday. Okay, so got all the tractors moved. I'll come out this afternoon once the sun is not shining right at these tractors, once it's overhead, and kind of get a picture of the work that they did yesterday and what they do to the ground, and then all their manure just helps fertilize the grass, so all this will come back greener next year. But they're all moved. The reason we stagger them is because if it rains, especially our property, everything washes this way. So if it rains, you don't want the manure from one chicken tractor going into the other one. So yeah, if it rains, you don't want the manure from one chicken tractor washing into the other one and getting the grass all nasty. So, 'cause by the time we got to the third one, there would be manure from two other tractors in there. So we stagger them. So that it's just fresh grass that it goes into and then it has time to wash away. So we did get a little bit of rain yesterday. They did not seem to be bothered by it. They went underneath the metal panels during the rain and then they came back out when it stopped raining. So they're all eating and scratching and eating some grass and grain right now. So they should be good to go. I'll come back and check on them later. And like I said, once the sun gets overhead, I'll show all the work that they did to the grass yesterday. But they should make this whole section of pasture a lot greener for eventually cows and sheep and other animals we plan to run through here. So okay, so the birds have been on pasture for a couple days now. They're doing well. We haven't lost any due to cold or predators or anything. We did have a little issue the second morning when we were moving them. One of them got caught in the back and its leg broke, so we had to put that one down. But the rest of them are doing well. You can see here where they started and where they've been and what they're doing to the grass. So this grass is going to be very, very green next year. So I do have to build a dolly for the backside, but I found that this moving dolly, this furniture dolly, works incredibly well. All I do is come over here, stick it under the back, and then we just pick up, and then we can, one of us can pull and one of us can hold the back up. So it doesn't work great for one person, you need two, but in the short term, until I get one of the Salatin style dollies built, we'll just have to use that for now so Tina and I can move the chickens together. But overall, they're doing well. They're moving right across the pasture, so